Another big issue in this country right now has to do with the legalization of marijuana. You gave an interview to the New Yorker's David Remnick, and you said that you thought smoking pot was a bad habit, but you didn't think it was any worse for a person than drinking. Now, that contradicts the official Obama administration policy, both on the website of the Office of National Drug Control policy, and also the fact that marijuana is considered a Schedule I narcotic along with heroin and ecstasy. Now, do you think you were maybe talking just a little too casually about it with Remnick and the New Yorker, or are you considering not making marijuana a Schedule I narcotic?
Well, first of all, what is and isn't a Schedule I narcotic is a job for Congress.
I think it's the DEA that decides.
It's not something by ourselves that we start changing. No, there are laws undergirding those determinations.
Would you support that move?
But the broader point, I stand by my belief, based, I think, on the scientific evidence, that marijuana for casual users, individual users, is subject to abuse just like alcohol is, and should be treated as a public health problem and challenge. But as I said in the interview, my concern is when you end up having very heavy criminal penalties for individual users that have been applied unevenly, and in some cases with a racial disparity. And I think that is a problem. Over the long term, what I believe is if we can deal with some of the criminal penalty issues, then we can really tackle what is a problem not just for marijuana, but also alcohol, also cigarettes, also harder drugs, and that is try to make sure that our kids don't get into these habits in the first place. And you know, the incarceration model that we've taken, particularly around marijuana, does not seem to have produced the kinds of results that we've set. But I do offer a cautionary note, and I said this in the interview. Those who think legalization is a panacea, I think they have to ask themselves some tough questions too. Because if we start having a situation where big corporations with a lot of resources and distribution and marketing arms are suddenly going out there peddling marijuana, then the levels of abuse that may take place
are going to be higher.